everyone. Welcome to your yoga practice today. It's Naomi, and today I have a yoga practice to share with you that is a soothing practice that you can do whenever you are feeling overstimulated, overheated, overwhelmed, whenever you just feel like you need to chill the F out, if you know what I'm talking about. This, as awesome as summer is, it's really, really easy to overdo it. Particularly on the mat, you know, and in physical activity. And when it's really hot, the last thing that you need is to overdo it. So this yoga practice is a soothing yoga practice for summer. I think you're gonna dig it. So let's get started. Oh, before we get started, I have a handy little block, really just to make your life a little easier. So use a block, use a bunch of books, use whatever you can, just to give yourself a little bit more support, okay? So start comfortable seat. Take a full breath in, full breath out. Okay, and then take your left hand to the outside of your right knee. Walk your right fingertips behind you. If you need to prop them up on that block, go ahead and do it. Just to give yourself more space. Full breath in, full breath out. Okay, another full breath in. And as you exhale, lean over to the left and just stretch your right arm over your ear. You can keep holding on to your right knee with your left hand. It's just going to give you a little bit more support as you stretch over. And then drop your right hand to the outside of your left knee. Take your left arm, cross it over to the left. Take a full breath in. Full breath out. And if you do need that extra support from the block, grab it. Remember, this is not the how hard can I push it class. This is the how much can I just be smooth and steady and still. And then keep holding onto your right knee or to left knee with your right hand. Lean to the right. Stretch your left arm over your ear. Take a full breath in. Full breath out. Another full breath in, and then reach left hand down out in front of you. Take your right arm out in front of you and walk forward. And you can take this block that you have, place it out in front of you, and rest your head on it. If you need it to be really high up. And just take a few breaths here, supported by the block or the floor if your hips are a bit more open. You know, we're already resting and we're just one pose in. And then come on back up and take the block out to the side, coming up to stand. Take a wide stance and fold forward and have that block handy. You don't need it yet, you might. And just fold forward. You might want it for underneath your head here. You can also set it to the side, and just fold in. Focus on your exhales, and encourage your body to be a little heavier. And keep in mind that heaviness is not stagnation. So water can be very heavy. So think fluid heaviness. Okay, so keep that in mind as you practice. Bend your right knee and lean over towards the right side. Shoot your butt way back behind you like it's going somewhere on its own. And that's mostly to help protect your right knee as you go lower. And then stay low. Crawl like a spider over to the left. Again, try to keep moving your hips back behind you because that'll keep your knee happier. If you just lean forward, it's gonna put a lot more pressure in your left knee. No bueno, nobody likes that. And then back through center, over to the right. Keep your left hand reaching over to the left. See how low you can go. Oh, my face touched the floor, that's exciting. And then back through center, keep your right hand over to the right as you bend your left elbow. Maybe get the left side of your face to the floor, maybe not. This side is tighter for me, so Don't force anything. Remember, this is the soothing practice back through center. Now this time, turn your right foot out. Have your block handy, so it's close towards your right leg, and walk your hands diagonally out away from your hips. You keep your left leg really steady and strong, so that as you walk out, you have a really solid anchor, something that supports you. Okay, take a full breath in. Full breath out. Get another full breath in. And then walk in towards your right leg. Lift your left heel up. Put your left knee down. Okay, shift your hips back and straighten your right leg. Okay, now as always, if you need something underneath your left knee for more support, make sure you have something there. Just breathe here. You might want that block again to give you a bit more of a boost. And take a full breath in. Oh, full breath out now. Walk over to the left, pivot on your left knee. Walk all the way over, put your right foot down so it points towards that long edge of your mat. Plant your left hand, extend your right arm over your ear. Oh, take a full breath in. Full breath out, and then come on back through center. Walk over, pivot on your left knee again. Bend your right knee and lower your forearms to the floor. And you might find, hey, it feels nice to cuddle with your block. You can put your forehead on the block again. Have it as high up as you like. If your forearms don't easily come to the floor, this is also an opportunity to use the block to bring yourself up a little bit, and you can still support your head if you want to by bringing your palms together and lifting your palms up, right? And you can rest your forehead there. So lots of ways, lots of ways here. Okay, now release that. And you're gonna turn your right foot out, shift to the right, lift the ball of your left foot up, and sit on your left butt. Okay, so you're kind of spinning around to the center. Grab a hold of your right ankle with your left hand and pull. So that as you pull on your right leg, you can lean over towards your left and extend your right arm over your ear. Now you might be able to reach down and grab your foot. It might feel nicer to have your hand behind your head. It's totally up to you. Just lean over towards your left leg. Don't worry if you can grab your leg or not. Soothing summertime practice. Let's focus on that steady inhale and exhale. And come on back up. Fingertips to the floor. Lift your hips. So you go forward with your chest. Hips up. Back through center. Oh yeah, there's another side. Bring your block with you. Turn your left foot out. Keep your right heel down. Walk your hands diagonally out away from your hips. And walk them out. Keep your right leg really steady and strong. And again, this is more about getting your hips down than getting your head down. So if you're like taking your head down, forcing it towards the floor, your hips are going to go up. You won't get that really sweet stretch in your hips. Come on back over towards your left foot. Lift your left or right heel. Put your right knee down. Straighten your left legs. Curl your toes back towards your body. Pull from your heel up towards your hip. So that traction inward is going to give more support to your hamstrings. A more active stretch, more stable. And then keep that as best you can as you walk to the center of your legs. Pivot on your right knee. Turn your left foot so it points towards that long edge. Walk over to the right, plant your right hand, left arm over your ear. Oh, heaven. down and back, over towards your left leg, pivot on your right knee, ball the foot up, and then bend your knee. And grab the block if you want, forearms to the floor, rest your head, or that other option of bringing your forearms to the block, palms together. Lift your palms up and support your head. Take a full breath in. Full breath out. And another full breath in. Full breath out. Full breath out, and then ditch the block. Turn your left foot so it's pointing towards the front corner of your mat, that front right corner, and then pivot, right? So pivot on your heel, sit your butt down, land on your right butt cheek. You have two, land on the right one. Left one will be lifted. Grab a hold of your left ankle with your right hand and pull. So you use strength and leverage to lean over towards your right leg. Maybe grab your right foot with your left hand. Maybe just have hand behind head. Whatever feels good. Take a full breath in. Full breath out. Come all the way back up. Place your right foot or left foot down. So left knee points to the left. Walk forward. So you're not going to be here for too long. Keep your hips heavy. Settle in. That's the good stuff. And walk over towards your right leg. Don't cross over yet. Stay on the inside. Again, you can bring the floor up as high up as you need it. You don't have to be quite so far forward. It's really up to you. Then you're going to cross your right arm over your right leg and your left arm over. And just like before, if you need a bit more height to help you twist, have that height. Lift up. Full breath in here. Full breath out. And then reach for your foot with your left hand, reach for your right foot with left hand, right foot with right hand, bend your elbows and fold in. And again, you might say, hey, I can't quite get there. So you can take your block, put it on your shin, on your thigh, stack it up as high as you want. If you can get your foot, that's great. Mostly you want to extend over your right leg and fold. Yeah, and then come on back up and switch legs. It's right leg in, left leg out. Okay. Walk forward. And you don't have to go very far. You can, if you like, come on down to your forearms if that's a place that you usually hang out. You can be here. But just take a few breaths here. We tend to rush a lot in the summer, and I can even feel myself want to. Like I'm saying to myself, oh, I really want this to be a 15-minute practice. I really want it to be quick. But honestly, you know, I just want you to feel good. So this is going to be a little bit more than 15 minutes. I'm sorry, you're welcome. Okay, and then walk over towards your left leg. Stay on the inside though. So just focus on getting this big stretch through the right side of your body, because that's what's opening up here. The left side, it's going to be harder. You'll feel that when you go into the twist. So just reach out again. You can be as high up as you need to. Okay, don't worry about where I am. Be in the place that soothes you. Right, overdoing it won't soothe you, that I can guarantee. Cross your left hand over your left leg, right hand over your left leg. If you need that block, you can put it underneath your hands here, press down though, and lift up so you can twist a bit more. And then reach for your left foot with your right hand. And you can keep your left hand on the ground or reach for your left foot with your left hand. Bend your elbows and fold in. Now you could also, if you have one, use a belt. Okay, so keep in mind, you don't have to reach for your foot. You can use whatever props will help you get there. That really tune into your breath, to your body, soothe. Oh, and then make your way back up. Grab your block, we're gonna do a supported bridge pose. If you're using books, books work for this too. You just have to, you know, coordinate a little bit. But you're gonna lie on your back. Take your block and place the block at that middle height underneath your sacrum. So what that's gonna feel like is a little bit of your butt is gonna be hanging off the edge, but it shouldn't be like on your lumbar spine, meaning the lowest part of your vertebra. So it's somewhere in between the top of your butt crack and the bottom of your spine. You can bend your elbows, point your fingers towards the sky, you can let your arms go. If you can get your arms around that block, you can interlace your fingers, I can't. But just allow the block to hold you here. Notice how badly you might want to do something. Stretch out your legs or fiddle with your arms or your hair or look to see what's happening. Keep your gaze pointed up. It's a lot safer for your neck to not turn your head from side to side here. And just keep your gaze up. Nothing to see, I promise. Oh yeah. I felt that exhale. That was a good one. I hope yours felt awesome too. If this height feels like it's too high, just lower it down so you're a little bit more towards the floor. If you want to try for a little bit more height, you can put it up on that highest height. See if you can find where it feels the best. It should still feel like you're being supported, not like you're being forced. So if when you put it up onto that highest, it feels hard, put it back down to the middle height. And you can stay here or draw your knees in towards your chest. Now you'll know if the block is in the right spot or not, if the block doesn't shoot out from underneath you. And you can extend your legs straight up. And here I can interlace my fingers, so I will. But mostly I'm just using my head for support, my shoulders, my hips on the block. And again, you do not have to lift your legs. You can keep your feet on the floor. Do make sure that there's plenty of space between your neck and the floor. So if your neck is kind of flattening down or crunching, lift your chin just slightly. And if you can't, then the block is too high. you're ready, bend your knees again. Slowly put one foot down and then the other if they're lifted. Release your arms if you tried to interlace your fingers. Just take a few more breaths here with your feet on the floor. And when you're ready, lift your hips, slide the block out. Take your arms out of the sides in a T. And just feel the heaviness of your body on the floor. Enjoy it. And then just one final little pose. Take your feet as wide as your mat. Drop your knees over to the right, let them fall. If you want a tiny bit more stretch through the left side of your body, extend your left arm over your ear. It's just a little stretch. If you want a little more, you can grab a hold of your left forearm with your right hand and pull over as you extend your left thigh down. Just a little. And then let that go, knees back up. Drop your knees over to the left. Feet still as wide as your mat. And again, you can extend your right arm alongside your ear. Or you can grab a hold of your right wrist with your left hand. And as you extend your right thigh down, reach your right arm over a little bit more. Just a little. Optional. And come on back to center, and again, just pause. You can knock your knees in, just let them rest. Bend your elbows. And let it soak in, this practice. Soak into your body. Side, push yourself up. There you have it. It's a little bit of yoga for your summer to hopefully make you feel a little refreshed without feeling overheated, to help soothe some of that summer intensity, and to give you a practice that you can do when you're just feeling a little bit overcooked and when you need something to cool you down and still feel really vibrant and alive. So let me know what you think of this practice in the comments below. As always, I love hearing what you think and what you'd like to see more. So tell me what you want to see and I will create it for you. And as always, if you are digging on this yoga practice, please, please, please subscribe in that bottom right corner so that you can see more good stuff from me every single week. A new video drops on Monday and I promise it will always be a good time on your yoga mat. So. Thanks for hanging out with me, and I will see you again really, really soon.